Hi guys, welcome to this quick review of this TeamMe Dice mini smart Wi-Fi camera or spy camera or whatever. So I have already been doing a large video where I show everything, like the unboxing, all the parts and how to set up the app, how to connect the app, how to use motion detection and everything. So if you need that video too, just make sure that you subscribe to my channel and you will get automatically this video too, or this review too, in the next couple of days. So this video is only about if you should or if it's recommended to buy or not. This is the camera itself. It's pretty small. It has the camera, it has some infrared and probably passive infrared. It is definitely not waterproof, so they say indoor, outdoor. It has large openings. Yeah, it has also no protection in the back for the micro SD card, for the on-off switch, for, I don't even know what that is, if this is a microphone or speaker, but I haven't seen anything like that. I haven't heard any sound in the recording. I haven't found any voice, so I think there's nothing here. And also for the micro USB chargers, no protection, so definitely not waterproof, even when it's right indoor, outdoor. It's pretty small, can charge it here, doesn't take too long, has 500 milliampere hours. And then the charge, when you are unplugging this, the charge lasts for exactly 1 hour and 30 minutes, at least based on my testing. So here they write, I think, 1 hour. In the listing, they say 2 hours. For me, it lasted 1.5 hours. So you get the free app, but you don't get the free cloud. It's actually easy to connect. I have connected it locally. You can, when you turn it on here, it will transmit an access point Wi-Fi, so you can connect with the app. You don't have to set up a login. You can directly connect, but of course the wireless range is then a little bit limited, but it's okay. It has like an SD or an HD mode. The camera is not too bad, but there's one thing which is really horrible, but apart from that, the footage is not so bad. It's stable, it's pretty good. And it has a second mode where you have to log in, and then you can connect the camera here to your normal router, and it can transmit everything to the cloud or just here to the app. For the cloud, you have to pay. It's pretty expensive. I think the cheapest mode is about $60 or $70 per year. It's a lot and it's not really good, so I'm going to show you that later. So this is what you get. You get also the 32 gigabytes of micro SD card. It works. A reset thing here, the reset here is on top. Press 5 seconds, then you have a total reset. You can connect it again to the Wi-Fi. Here we have a mount with a sticker here, can move the thing around. You can also use it without, just like put it down. Here's a magnetic thing, just point it towards something. Usually it's good. You don't even have to really glue it or really stick it. You can use it battery powered for 1.5 hours, but you can use it like wired with the micro USB cable. So you can use it from a normal outlet or from a power bank. So this is working. Everything works actually not bad. Is it really worth the price? Here you can see some cloud events which I've been recording yesterday. Let's go back to yesterday and we can see that. So the recording is really bad, I have to tell you, unfortunately, and motion detection has also not been working really good. So I'm a little bit closer here for the footage. This is something which it has been recording. You can see it's moving. I mean, the cloud is really working. You can see the trees are moving around, shaking, but what you can see, of course, I mean, the colors, sky is blue, the grass is green, the tree is brown more or less, but the, like, the leaves or the branches of these palm trees look like in a Barbie toy video. So they are pink or purple, but not like they are. I mean, they are really green. I can guarantee they are not pink or purple. They are they have really nice green, so it's horrible. And also motion detection, yeah, it says this footage contains motion detection, yeah, just somewhere, so it's total useless. When you record something, I mean, when it's recording something to the cloud, when you have subscribed to the cloud, you would expect that it's showing motion detection and alert you. As far as I've been able to see, it won't do that. So only when you're watching, then after that, when you're going to the cloud and watching the footage, and you get to an area where it sees somebody like walking around, then in a sudden it will say, oh, motion found. That's not the idea, of course. You should expect that something like that, which is called like also a security camera, and you pay for a very expensive cloud, would be able to alert you right on time when it happens, not after that, when you're watching the footage. And I had even footage here where I was walking here from the trash bin directly towards the camera, and no matter how close I've been, it has not been detecting anything. I've been waving in front, I have been using a wooden stick, it has not been detecting anything. So I still have no idea what it's detecting. I think it doesn't have like PIR, it doesn't have really motion detection. So just in the cloud, probably, just when the artificial intelligence in the cloud is saying, okay, there was something, then it's saying, yeah, movement. So, but that's not the idea. So actually for that, it's totally useless, and for me, definitely doesn't work. So regarding that, yeah, definitely not a good thing, and definitely doesn't work for me. But are specific things, if you like something super small, and if you're okay with 1.5 hours battery runtime, and you're good with pink trees, yeah, maybe it could work for you. I'm not saying it's totally not working, it's working somehow, but it's very, very limited. By the way, you can try it out, 30 days free cloud. After that, it's going to be expensive, but there are definitely better cameras, like especially with the Vice Cam, like the V2, which you can buy now on Amazon, and there's a new one, the V3, in December coming out. If you want to buy something now, yeah, just go with the V2. I have two of these cameras since 2 years. They are doing a great job. Yeah, they are much better. There's also Vice Cam Outdoor for $50, the Vice Cam V2 you can buy for around $20-$25, even cheaper, comes with free cloud. Yeah, it doesn't have battery power, but you have to decide what you want. If you need battery power, then go with Device Cam Outdoor. If you don't need like something outside battery, then go with Device Cam V2. But this thing here just really doesn't work. I mean, we have 24/7 recording. Yeah, that's good so far as it looks. We can also work without the cloud, but of course, then it's a little bit of a hassle to find the real footage, but we can do that. It's working even when we are on battery power. It's recording the whole time, but we can have this too also with the Vice Cam V2, but we cannot have this with other battery operated cameras like Sumimals or so. But from my side, I would definitely go with either the Vice Cam V2 or the Vice Cam Outdoor, but this thing here is just not working for me. And yeah, that's it for now. But I still hope I've been able to help you a little bit with this video. If you have any questions or comments, just write to the comment section below. I'm always happy to talk about these things. And if you like the video, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.